Today we're going to learn how to light paint. Light painting is a process in which you use a DSLR and a light source to create images like these.
Okay, here are the things you'll need. A tripod, a DSLR, a light source, a dark place to shoot. Even though it's not dark right now, because we're great people and chose to shoot this in the morning. And your...
imagination.
In photography, there are three main settings for your camera. Aperture, shutter speed, and ISO. All of these play a vital role in light painting and for photography in general. Aperture is important because it controls the amount of light shown in your image.
The shutter speed also controls the amount of light in your image, but in light painting, the shutter should be more than a couple seconds so you can complete your entire painting. That's perfect.
Lastly, ISO controls your sensor sensitivity to light and your graininess. For example, if you shoot an image at ISO 100, your image will be sharp, but if you are in a low light situation, your sensor will not capture enough light for your image.
On the other hand, a high ISO, such as 2400, will efficiently pick up enough light in a low lit situation. However, at the same time, it will produce a lot of grain.
The balance of these three settings is essential for producing the perfect light painting image.
Now that you know your camera's basic settings, we can start the process of light painting. Step 1. Get your DSLR, light source, and tripod. Step 2. Put your camera on your tripod and find an area to shoot. Step 3. Put your camera on manual and play with your settings. The ability to take pictures in the darkness does not come overnight.
I would recommend starting out at ISO 400 to 800, using a wide aperture, about 3.5, and using a longer shutter speed, around 8 to 30 seconds, depending on how long it will take you to make your light painting. If your shutter speed is 8 seconds, make sure your aperture is wide enough so it can capture the right amount of light. But if your shutter speed is 30 seconds, make sure it's smaller so the amount of light is not too great.
Perfect.
Now, just think of an image to produce. Let's go.
Now that we're outside, all we have to do is think of an image to produce and how to use our three settings, ISO, aperture, and shutter speed to produce the image we want. Okay, so first, I want to get my friend Caden over here on this cool hoverboard thing that has a light. So the light's gonna make streaks because of the shutter speed's length. And let's just try it out. Okay, so since it's dark outside, we had to compromise on our lighting situation with an iPhone. But, okay, so I want him to go in a... Okay. Okay, before I was rudely interrupted by that pickup truck, I was saying I wanna get my friend on this going in a zigzag motion to get a cool painting from the wheels right there, or whatever that light is behind there. Okay, obviously the first step is to put your camera onto your tripod and all this, but the main thing is your settings. So right now it's pretty dark outside, so I want to put ISO 800, and it's going to take him a while to move around, so maybe 8 seconds, and a low aperture so it can capture all those lights. Okay, so put your lens on manual focus so it doesn't try to autofocus and make your picture all blurry. Okay, so let's see how this turns out. This is just a test shot, so it doesn't really matter that much. As you can see, the image we produced is overexposed and just overexposed. So I need to either make my shutter speed slower, which I don't want to do, or make my ISO lower, which will produce a sharper image, which is what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna shoot at ISO 400, which is gonna take us half a stop down, and maybe F 7? 7.1? Okay. Ready? We're gonna retry again. Let's see how this goes.
After playing around with our settings for a couple more minutes, we found the perfect balance. ISO 400, F10, and a 15 second shutter allowed for enough light to get in, Caden to draw the path with the hoverboard, and for there not to be too much grain, but for the light to be still captured.
After capturing the images from outside, we came inside and took these pictures using a little headlight and some string, showing that a little ingenuity can go a long way. Now that you know the basic settings of your camera and how to take light painting pictures, go out and take some. Thank you for watching, and please like and subscribe. At 25,000 likes, we're going to give away a f2.8 16 to 35 millimeter lens cap. Okay, goodbye.
Today we're going to... Hi, I'm Lizzie.
Okay, here are the things you'll need. A tripod,
So you can complete...
The perfect balance of these three settings.
I hate it.
Okay,
ready? 3, 2.
No, thank you. No.